Have you seen Apple like this turn into this? Hi, my name is Hyrule and welcome to New KL Mindset. One of the key reasons as to why sliced apple turned to brown is due to the presence of enzyme called polyphenol oxidase. This enzyme is a type of protein and it mediates the biochemical reactions. In case of apple, the enzyme catalyzes the formation of a biomolecule called quinone. Quinone acts as a precursor, a starter, to complex multiple reactions producing a pigment called melanin. And yes, melanin is the same pigment that you have on your skin. In fact, plant carries more of this pigment than us human beings. In food industry, enzymatic browning has resulted in up to 50% losses for tropical fruits. But the thing about enzyme is that it can be controlled. For example, a sliced apple like this, soaked in the salt water, would maintain its original color like this. So in other words, the salt acts as a preservative. Other preservation techniques, for example, the use of steam, or the use of freezing or refrigerations, the use of fruit acid, citric acid for example, or packaging technologies would allow the enzyme to be controlled and reduced and by the end of the day increase the shelf life. But not all enzymes produce undesirable outcomes. In fact, food industry rely heavily on enzymes as it is generally recognized as safe. The main reason of this application is that it helps the processing by improving textures, appearance and sensory profiles. For example, in baked goods, the use of amylase increases bread volumes and also speed up dough proofing. Another example, for example, the use of pectinase in fruit juice industry would allow the breakdown of pectin and increase the yield of juice. Advances of food enzyme in food safety and health, for example, the use of asparaginase in high carbohydrate fruit would allow them to reduce the level of acrylamide, which is a carcinogen or a cancer agent. Imagine that eating french fries with a dash of this enzyme would be something that is beneficial. In oil and fat industry, the use of lipase, for example, produce the trans-free margarines and shortenings. And in dairy industry, for example, the use of lactase would allow the removal of the lactose from milk, which is very beneficial for those with lactose intolerance. In our food engineering and technology sections, our students will learn and apply the three fundamentals: food science, technology and food engineering. The course is comprehensive and we provide competence and reliable human capitals. Our high employability rate is the testimony of our success in providing the hands-on experience aligned to the industrial needs. So I hope you all learned something new today. For more information about New KL Mindset, please check out our website at mindset.newkl.edu.my. Thank you very much. And I look forward to see you soon.